Sometimes when you say mercy, people always say, well, God will forgive you, God will save you. Amen. But mercies, God is a God of mercies. That means that all of the mercies, the Bible says his mercies are new, what, every morning. Healing is a mercy. How many can say that? Salvation is a mercy. Amen. Protection and provision, all of these are what? Mercies. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. God being able to lead and direct and guide you day by the Holy Spirit. All of these are tender mercies. Amen. These are things that God is doing for us. Amen. Praise God. Despite the fact that many times we are not really, amen, doing or living for God as we should be living for him. Amen. So my subject again, the Lord's greatest attribute, and which is compassion, the Lord's compassion. Amen. Now people many times read Psalms 145 verses 8 and 9. This is the scripture text that we have used over and over. Okay, but I want you to feel that I go over these things, and some people say he talked that last Sunday. He preached that three or four times already. But these scriptures that I'm giving you are scriptures that if you absorb them and begin to use these scriptures in your prayer, speak these things to God whenever you want to express your love and your adoration for God, use these scriptures in your prayer. Amen. I'm learning even to not only use them, amen, but to sing them, because many of them are psalms. And that's when the blessings really begin to open up and you really begin to get, amen, praise God, a firmer grip on, amen, the love of God, the love and concern of God. Now this scripture, I'm going to talk real low today because everybody, amen, is in the Thanksgiving mood and you don't want to be bothered too much. We're just going easy, real easy with you. Amen. The scripture says the Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great mercy. I have a tune for that. Amen. Didn't the Bible say sing psalms, hymns, and scripture songs?
Yes.
Amen. So why don't we do them? Amen. Why don't we do them? Amen. We need to start doing that. Amen. The Lord is gracious, full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies, his mercies are tender. His tender mercies are over all of his works. Okay, I love that, I love that. His tender mercies are over all of his works. Amen. Now the Lord is gracious. You define that gracious simply means that a person is inclined to show favor. Amen. A person is inclined to show favor. And that's their disposition. They just automatically respond in terms of showing favor. They want to bless you. They want to do something for you or help you. Amen. That is what gracious means, inclined or disposed to showing favor. Amen. Do you know anybody around you that's gracious? Every time you connect with them, they want to do something for you. Amen. They want to give you some money. Or those kind of people you're kind of attracted to. Gracious people, people that will put a $20 bill in your hand. Amen. How many like those kind of folks?
Amen.
Amen. Give you a nice smile, encourage you, a word of exhortation. Those people we are drawn to because we like, amen, to be cared for. Amen. Now, the scripture says, full of compassion, full of compassion. Amen. If I had a glass of water, and if I filled it to the brink, you couldn't put any more water in that glass, right? So that's the way God's compassion. Scripture says his compassions, they never fail. They never fail. Amen. His mercies are what new everyone. The Bible says if it hadn't been for the Lord's mercies, we would have what? We would all been consumed. Amen. Have you thought about that? If it hadn't been for God's protection, provision, blessings. Amen. He has angels all around you. Is that right? How many know that if it weren't for those angels, anything just could come in and what? Work havoc in your life. But he's got angels. Amen. How many let those angels? All what? Encamp around about them that what? Fear him. Amen. So I'm just happy that if it hadn't been for God's mercies, we all would have been consumed. His mercies are new. I like that. His mercies are new. This is an imitation. Amen. All singers that sings about God, great is thy faithfulness. That's where they get it from. Amen. Great is thy faithfulness. His mercies are new every morning. Amen. Because his compassions, they fail not. Amen. So, compassion and mercy means the same thing in the scripture. Y'all already understand that. Compassion and mercy, they mean the same thing. And the Hebrew noun translated mercy is translated compassion all through the Old Testament. Amen. So, these are the things that God wants us to get deeply embedded into our spirits, how merciful. You know, God is not a person that's trying to take something away from you, trying to lack the policemans. How many know the policemans always hide out somewhere to try to catch somebody that's going to what, break the speed limit? How many have got caught by one of them? How many times? He just waiting out, high now, for somebody to what? Break the law. So they can what? So they can pounce on them and give them a ticket. Oh, that's a bad feeling when you see that red light. That light just circling around. Amen. Especially if it's behind your car. Oh, that's a bad feeling. Sometimes your stomach's sinking. It kind of sinks. Through the floor almost, my Lord. But God is not a person that's seeking an opportunity to what? To try to catch you in something so you can inflict harm on you. Amen. He's not trying to take something from you. He's trying to what, get something to you. He ain't no tight-fisted God. How many know some tight-fisted folk? Amen. One thing about a tight fist, you can't get nothing in it. And you can't get nothing without on it. And you can't get nothing what in it. You better be a tight-fisted. God ain't a tight-fisted God. Amen. The Bible says he openeth his hands wide. Ooh, I love that. Amen. He openeth his hands wide and satisfies the desire of every living thing. Amen. That's enough to dance about right there. He opened his hands what? Wide, and he satisfied the desire of what? Every living thing. Amen. Now that's in the same book of Psalms 145, verse 16. And we've been studying a whole lot of things because I think that along the same line, Romans 8, we mentioned that God didn't withhold his only son. God didn't withhold his only son. Now these are some of these compassion scriptures that when you begin to meditate them, it really begins to register and it really begins to build your faith and it gives you a whole lot of joy. Amen. It gives you a whole lot of, how many know that you can eat the word, you can feed on the word until you just get real happy on the inside. Anybody know I got real happy on the inside? until you just didn't know what to do. Sometimes you want to smile, you want to laugh, you want to run, you want to jump, you want to walk. Amen. But that's what somebody said, the word will make you shout and glad, fight mad. Shout and glad, fight mad. But this scripture always registers with me because I don't want people to. See, God is disposed to show in favor, and we never should look upon God as somebody that's trying to take something away from you or trying to keep you from what heaven. Amen. Everything that's needed in order for your life to be complete. You should ever look at God as somebody trying to take something from you. Amen. Because if he really wanted to take something from you, didn't want you to have life, this is what he said. I am come that you might have what? Life. And that you might have life what? More abundantly. He wants you to have what? Abundant life. Everybody just say abundant life. Everybody just say abundant life. Amen. So if he didn't want you to have abundant life, all he would have had to done is to what? Held back Jesus. Amen. Now, see, all of these blessings, now all of the Jehovah names, y'all can repeat those, right? Y'all know them all. Jehovah what? Y'all scared to say it. Okay, Jehovah Shammah. The Lord is what? Always with me. Amen. Always with me. Just say that. The Lord is always with me. That's what Jehovah Shammah means. See, he was there, amen, before he went to the cross because it was already established when he came into the world, amen, when he was just the Son of God in terms of spiritual Son. He wasn't body. It was already decided and agreed upon that Jesus would come into the world to be everything to all people, whatever their needs were, to cover every aspect of their need from the time that they were born to the time that they went out of this world. It was already established. Now, he was able to do that on the basis of the redemption that was to come, amen, many years, amen, later. But we were, every person that was created were able to draw from the benefits of his redemption even before the redemption was consummated. That's the way it was determined. He was a lamb slain before the what? Foundation of the world. And he came into the world so that he could be all of these Jehovah's for us. Every need you will ever have. How many got some needs now? Amen. Praise God. How many got a lot of needs now? Amen. Now, we're going to show you that God has already made provisions for all of your needs. Already. That was done a long time ago. It was consummated 2,000 years ago. But even under the old covenant, amen, God was still what? A God of mercy. How do you understand? He still was gracious, full of compassion, and he was able to display and release those blessings and mercies on people based on the provisions that he would make for them, amen, at the cross, but they could draw from them even in the old what? Amen, dispensation. Amen. How many know that God was a healer under the old covenant? Amen. Y'all ain't said that. How many know that God was always with those that were with him?
Amen.
Is that right? God said keep covenant with people that obey him and do what he says up to 1,000 generations. That's a long time. Amen. Pray he keeps covenant. He ain't slack. He ain't slack concerning his promises. God ain't a man that he should lie. Neither the Son of Man that he should repent. If God spoke it, amen, that thing that God spoke shall what come to pass. Amen. Somebody said there hasn't failed one word. One word. I'm talking soft today. Amen. There hasn't failed what? One word of all of God's good promises. Amen. I mean, who else could you make a statement like that about? Amen. There hasn't failed. I know Brother Beauty's like his husband. But Sister Deborah said, I got to think about that. There hasn't failed one word of all of God's good promises. God's, amen. The scripture says this, his covenant, he'll never break it, neither alter the word that has gone out of his mouth. See, these Jehovah's are some big issues. Jehovah Shammah, the Lord my peace. How many got a a good amount of peace now? I mean, you might not be at number 10, but you're kind of at 9 or 8, somewhere 7. Amen. You're pretty peaceful because maybe some bills you got you can't pay, so you can't be at 10. Unless you know how to cast your care, all your cares on it. So the daughter saying, take the burden to the Lord and leave him there. If you're able to do that, amen, maybe you could be at a 10 and still broke. Amen. How many can say amen? Jehovah Shalom. Everybody say Jehovah Shalom.
Jehovah Shalom.
Amen. What does that mean? The Lord is my peace. He's always been Jehovah Shalom to people that were trusting. But under the old covenant, amen, you can get a much greater degree of whatever you're dealing with under the new covenant, because the new covenant is better than the what? The old. So he came that all that you enjoyed under the old could be what? Magnified. Amen. Because you don't have to. I mean, see, all you have to do now, amen, in order for these blessings to be released into your life, you just have to what? Receive Jesus. Amen. And then begin to get a revelation of his word and begin to agree with his word. Pray in the spirit. Amen. And the scripture says that, amen, all things are ours. See, this is what grace is all about. Let me just give you, amen, the definition that we have adopted for grace. Grace is the sum total of all that God has done for you through Christ. The sum total of all that God has done for you through Christ. Let me see. I'm a teacher. Repeat that. The sum total of what all that God has done for us in Christ. Amen. It's all of God's mercy, all of his love, all of his compassion, all of his goodness. Everything that God has, amen, grace is the sum total of all that God has done for us. Amen. How many know that God has done an awful lot for us?
Amen.
But let me just complete that, because it wouldn't be complete unless I gave you the remaining part of that definition. Is the sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ and all that God is presently doing for us through the Holy Spirit. See, that's where the new covenant outstrips the old, because God can do all of these things now through the Spirit, through the Holy Ghost. Amen. Somebody used to say, I got a telephone in my bosom and I can ring them up from my heart. You don't have to go through Moses. Amen. Grace and peace. The Bible says the law came through Moses, but grace and peace came through what? Christ. Is that right?
Amen.
You can get results by praying yourself. Jesus said, whatsoever thing ye desire when you pray. Scripture also, whatever you ask the Father, in what? My name, the Father will give it to you. See, this wasn't possible for everybody under the old covenant. Amen. Whatever you demand done in Jesus' name, amen. Jesus said, I'll do that. I'll make it happen for you. Amen. Praise God. So all of these, Jehovah's, the Lord my provider, the Lord my banner, the Lord my shepherd, the Lord my righteousness, the Lord my physician. He does all of that through the Spirit. Amen. He does it all through the Spirit. That's the reason why it's important for us to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. It's good for us to develop our spirit. and really pray in the Spirit, is that right?
Amen.
So that we can get a revelation of what God has done for us, because He's done so much for me, someone said, I cannot even tell it all. The sum total of all that God has done for us through Christ and all that God is presently doing for us through the Holy Spirit is the way that you would define grace. So when you get grace, I mean, the grace of God is a big package. A big package. Amen. Somebody said, I can do all things through what? Christ. That what? Strengthens me. Somebody used to say, greater is what? He that is what? In me. Amen. How many are glad that God is in you?
Amen.
See, God wasn't in people to dwell within them like He is, amen, today in us in the new dispensation. Amen. How many of them know it's a lot better when God can guide you and lead you from the inside? Amen. He couldn't do that under the old covenant, so their blessings were what? He was a good God, full of compassion. But there was just so much He could what do for them because He wasn't able to what? To do it all for everybody at the same time because He had to what? Work through what? Leaders. Angels. But now He works through the Holy Ghost. How many glad you have the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on, repeat this one. Greater is He that is in me.
Greater is He that is in me.
Say it again. Greater is He,
greater is He
that is in me.
Than
he that is in the world. Amen. Praise God. Now, here's the scripture I want you to write down because we stopped off at God is not a tight-fisted God, but God wants you to be. He's a gracious God. He wants you to have a full supply. Amen. So when we talk about God's compassion, we're not just saying God is able. We are not just saying that God is willing. But we are saying that God is full of what? Eager yearning. In other words, He just doesn't want to bless you, but He wants to bless you beyond measure. He wants to bless you more than you want to be blessed. He wants to bless you more than you can conceive of His ability to bless you. Amen. We got a good God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We got a good God. Now, here's the scripture that convinced me. And the scripture that I will always, in the course of a prayer meeting, I will always try to get this released. He that spared not His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all, how shall He not with Him also freely give us all things? Amen. Look at that. Amen. He that spared not His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all. See, God didn't spare Christ. Amen. Jesus didn't even spare His own life. Jesus said that, amen, I'll lay down my life. Amen. God gave His only begotten Son. He was in the bosom of His Father. In other words, bosom buddy is somebody that's very, very what, close to you. The closest thing to God's heart was His what? His own Son. But God didn't even spare Him, but He delivered Him up for us all. Jesus didn't even spare Himself. He said that nobody can take my life from me. I got power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up. He said, I lay it down. He was not selfish. He was not tight-fisted. He was not trying to hold back to keep you from what? Receiving. The full range. Well, I love that. The full range of benefits that you would need in order to be victorious in every realm of your life. He didn't hold back anything. He didn't hold back anything. But He what? Delivered Him up for us all. How shall He not with Him also freely? I like that word freely. Amen. It doesn't sound like a tight-fisted God to me. That seems like a God that's full of eager yearning. That He's waiting, ooh, His eyes are just what? Running to and fro. Y'all like that scripture, though? His eyes are what? Running to and fro. How many know that God's eyes are running?
Amen.
Now, long as God's eyes are running and the devil is walking, I'm in pretty good shape. Oh, yes. His eyes are what? Running to and fro. And all his eyes are what? Trying to spot somebody that will what? That will open up, that will position themselves to receive the blessing that he wants to pour out upon them in great abundance or profusion. He's just looking for an opportunity for somebody that will what? Meet the condition. The conditions are not high. Is that right? Sometimes we think, well, God's condition was so rough, man. I can't even, amen, begin to even prepare to receive what God had. Amen. But my yoke is easy and my burden is what? Light. Amen. God wouldn't have gone through all of that trouble to give up his own son, and the son gave up his life, if it still was going to be hard for you to receive what he has, what, freely given you. Hallelujah. You know, it's almost as easy. I'm going to be truthful with it. It's almost as easy as letting go and let God. Hey, boy, you find a good hot sister around here that'll open her mouth real wide. So, Lord, I want everything you got for me. Hallelujah. I mean, when they open up, they say, Lord, live, die, sink, or swim. Whatever God got, amen, praise God, you can count me in. Yeah. Amen. So those are the kind of people that God is what? He's looking for. He's looking for people that will what? Not be just sophisticated. Nothing wrong with being sophisticated. You know, I like to see people sophisticated. So Tyree looks kind of sophisticated. But you can't out holler her. Amen. She'll open up her mouth. Amen. Because she knows, amen, that the joy of the Lord is what? Our strength. So God is looking for people that will what? Open up, open the door, and what? Let him in. That's what his eyes are what? Running to and fro around the earth. That's what he's trying to find. Now, I remember these scriptures, that 2 Corinthians 16:9. Amen. I don't have to be, you don't have to be no rocket scientist, but remember just a handful of scriptures that can enhance your prayer life. A few scriptures that can what? Bless your socks off, that can really add a new dimension to your prayer life. To me, his eyes running to and fro throughout the whole earth, seeking whom we, amen, seeking a heart that's perfect before him. To me, I can use that in prayer. I said, God, thank you. You're looking, your eyes are running. Amen. Lord, here I am. You don't have to look no further. Amen. I'm the man. I'll open up and I'll let you in. Okay, so that shows that God is not a tight-fisted, he's not trying to keep you from receiving. He's not like that policeman down there waiting for somebody to run a light to give you a ticket. Bible says, whoever need wisdom, let him ask of God, who giveth to every man what liberally and upbraideth not. That upbraid simply means that he's not looking for some